In this lesson, I will talk about the necessity of reconciliation, definition of reconciliation, as well as the eight societal beliefs. Reconciliation is needed as a crucial factor for stabilizing peace after conflict and for transforming the relationship among former disputants. Reconciliation after conflict transformation continues to go beyond conflict resolution as well as addresses emotional and cognitive impediments in order to normalize and stabilize peaceful relations. In general, reconciliation might be applied in different types of conflict, like conflicts within a family, intercommunal, ethnic, civil wars, and international conflict. Reconciliation regularly takes place within divided societies and within a country after interreligious, inter-ethnic, or interracial conflicts that involve vast violence. Many casualties tend to be prolonged and emerge hatred and enmity perceptions. In other words, reconciliation is not so important process in all intergroup conflict. This instrument only refers to the intergroup conflicts continue for at least two decades and involve vast violence. And as a result of violent conflict, substantial gathering of hatred and enmity that can be called collective memories are perpetrated by events, actions related to the conflict. After wars, conflict-related beliefs change as societal beliefs and combine into ethos. Less violent conflicts are conflicts that civilians on each side are wounded, injured and killed. Properties are damaged and destroyed and local people are forced to move their motherlands as refugee or internal displaced persons. Bartel and Benning argue that reconciliation refers to sorrowful issues of post-conflict on purpose of establishing ground for normal, peaceful relations. In this sense, this phenomenon requires mutual will by both sides to apologize regarding previous mutual forgiveness, transgressions for peace agreement. Since the reconciliation is consensual and a reciprocal process, this cannot be implemented by only one side or an external party, for instance, a mediator. This process is more likely to move on slowly and naturally with intervention of leadership, and the leaders of both sides have to step jointly and simultaneously. According to them, reconciliation is applied when societies engage in any conflict, emerge widely divided beliefs, motivations, attitudes and emotions which defend protections to the conflictive purposes, delegitimizes the adversary, maintain conflict and deny chances of peaceful resolution and obstruct the progress in peaceful relationships. To identify the importance of reconciliation, two necessary classifications of conflict is required to be illustrated. First one pays attention to the result of the conflict and conditions of the conflict and sides after the solution of conflict that they will live together within one entity or they will live under different separate system. Since the post-disputants that will live together in one peaceful society, they have to establish mechanisms that instigate integration. In opposite case, rival societies have to build mechanism of intergroup relationships in two different entities that involve various processes outcomes. With regard to the second classification, it refers to the attributed responsibility for the outbreak of the conflict and especially for the negative acts committed during the conflict. We can argue that this is common perception of conflicting parties in the world. Now, let's talk about the eight societal beliefs that I emphasized in the beginning of this video. Bartel emphasizes that building of peaceful relationships between conflicting groups depends on the successful reconciliation process, requires change of the conflictive ethos and shaping of alternative peace ethos. According to Katz and Rakowski, when the conflict erupts, the society members of the both sides embark to shape certain pattern of perception on their minds regarding the reasons, causes of conflict, intention of opposite side. Briefly, they engage in cognitive activities. Moreover, members of the societies form different beliefs like utility and mobilization in order to cope with the conflict situation, external threats. Bartel identifies eight beliefs that assist to form the reality within the war conflict-torn societies as a result of intractable conflict. Firstly, societal beliefs regarding the justness of one's own goals. Concerns that importance of explanations, reasons, and rationales about the purposes caused to the conflict. Secondly, society beliefs regarding security emphasize the necessity of personal security survival of nation. Thirdly, societal beliefs of positive self-image that deal with the ethnocentric inclination to ascribe positive values, traits and behaviors in its own society. Fourthly, society beliefs of one's own victimization engage in self-presentation as a victim, concentrating on the unfair harm, atrocities and evil deeds committed by the rival. Fifthly, societal beliefs of the delegitimizing the opponent that take into consideration denial of humanity of rival through negative feature of characterization, dehumanization, use of negative political labels, as well as negative group comparing. Sixth, societal beliefs of patriotism establish attachment for the society and country by applying propaganda, loyalty, care, love, and sacrifice. Seventh, society beliefs of unity addressed to the necessity of ignoring internal conflicts and incompatibilities in intractable conflict combined forces against external threats. And finally, eighth, societal belief of peace addresses to peace final or at latest desire of members of society. Later stresses that the reconciliation continues four elements: truth, mercy, justice and peace in intra-societal conflict. Truth identifies open assertion of the past or history. Mercy suggests pardon of building new peaceful relations. And justice refers to restoring and positive social reformation. At last, peace is about well-being and security issues of all parties of conflict and their common peaceful future. Conversely, reconciliation as a study between states requires building of peace by establishing a new culture, cultural, social, economic, and political relations between the former enemies. Thank you very much for watching us.